Let's first get precise in two dimensions. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about beginning our fundamental steps of mastering precision mesh modeling within Blender 2.91. We're first going to master it within two dimensions, and then we'll jump into 3D. And once again, we find ourselves on a nice, fresh Blender file. We now understand the fundamentals of Blender and how everything sort of relates to one another, and we're ready to get on with learning precision modeling. I'm going to break this up into two main sections, which is 2D and 3D. So the reason why, and it may sound a little bit obvious, is every 3D object is made up of a whole bunch of 2D faces. Now, you are well equipped to deal with everything we're about to cover because you understand the fundamentals going through this whole course so far. So what we're going to basically do here is master 2D before we bring 2D to 3D. So before we do that, I want to set up my scene just a little bit, and you may want to do the same. So I'm going to turn on the statistics here so that I have them up here and not on the bottom right, as I find them more visible there. And from now on, I'm always going to have these up here. So I'm also going to go File, Defaults, Save Setup File, and save this like that. Now, for those that are following along as the videos come out, we need to add one more add-on because I forgot to add it right at the start. So let's just quickly go into our add-ons and let's chuck in Mesh, Edit Mesh Tools, and turning that on, making sure we save our preferences just in case, and there we have it. So let's get on with it. What we're basically planning to do for this video is creating the net of a cube. So let's select everything. Let's hit X and delete it all. Now we're going to go ahead and create our starting point. And our starting point is going to be a single vertex. So let's go Shift A, Mesh, Single Vertex, Add Single Vertex. If you're joining into the course right this moment, there's two videos down below to make sure that you have all the add-ons that you need for this, as well as making sure your scene is in millimeters. So let's add this vertex in, and you may have noticed what's just happened. We've been thrown into edit mode. And the reason for this is a single vertex doesn't really exist on its own. If you think about it, a single vertex is as useful as a single origin point with no mesh. So just be aware that that's why we're here. So let's hit 7 to go into our top view because we're going to be working within 2D for now. And now let's go ahead and make sure that we have our vertex selected. If you can't select it, it might be that you're in edge mode and it's impossible to select a vertex like that, or in face, and you've got to make sure that you're in vertex selection to select your vertex. Now what we're going to do is not duplicate, but extrude this vertex. Now there is an extrusion right here, but we're going to use the shortcuts because we know how powerful they are. The shortcut is E, and there we go. You can see we've extruded this vertex with another vertex, and there's an edge connecting them both. Now I'm going to straight away go ahead and put in 1, and you're going to see that it's automatically constrained it. This is because we're in the top view and we've put in a unit. So it says, okay, you obviously want to go just 1 millimeter with this cube. Where do you want to go? And it's just going to randomly constrain you. I want to go on the Y, so I'm going to type in Y and hit enter. Okay, from this point, we need to go ahead and create our first square. Now, there's two ways of going about it. I'm going to show you the quick way and the slightly slower way because we need to understand both of these when we're doing this. So let's go and do the quick way, which is actually going to be edge selection. Select the edge we have just created. And now when we extrude this edge, you're going to see that we create a face, 3 edges and 2 vertices. So if we hit 1, hit enter, here it is. You can see if we go into our vertex selection, we have those 2 other vertices that have been added in. Okay, great. Let's undo that and let's do it the slow way, which is going into vertex selection, selecting the vertex we just created, extruding this vertex, typing in 1, hitting enter, extruding this vertex, typing in 1, saying that we want to go in the Y in the other direction though. So let's hit minus and let's hit enter. Okay. From this point, you might think that to close this up, we need to extrude it out and place it on top, and that's going to automatically merge the vertices. Well, default Blender does not do that. There is a way of doing that, and I will show you that later on, but what we have to do is fuse these two vertices together. When we fuse these two vertices with F, we get an edge. However, fusing and filling sort of have the same shortcut. The reason being is when there isn't enough information, so only two vertices, it's going to fuse these two vertices with an edge. However, when you have a whole bunch of edges and vertices, and then you use the fuse command, it does a fuse and a fill. And when you fill in edges, you create a face. Great, so we're here. However, I'm not comfortable going into faces just right this minute. So let's learn how to delete faces without deleting all the information to build them. So edges and vertices. So we're going to face selection and then let's hit X. And you're gonna see that our delete menu has got a lot more complicated. There's a whole bunch more settings now. Well, and there's three for face. Let's go through each one of these. Well, if we delete faces, that's going to delete everything that associated with that face. So the other one is only edges and faces. Well, if we go into vertex selection with one, you're going to see that's left all the vertices behind. And then we have the one that we're looking for, which if we hit X, it is only faces. This leaves the vertices and edges in place. Great. So let's select what we've just created here. And now let's duplicate it with Shift D and move it out to the side. So now we know how to fuse meshes, and we know these are both the same object, because if we go into object mode and we select one of these, they are both selected. If they aren't, remember that we've got to join it with our Control J that we learned in our fundamentals. So let's go back into edit mode. And let's say that we want to go ahead and move this here. Let's use our CAD transform. So Alt-C or whatever shortcut you have set up. G, make sure that you are on vertex selection. So it's V. And then let's go ahead and move this right on top of there. Now, we can see right here, if you aren't aware, the selection should sort of carry on along the edge if that was the same vertex. So if we were to do a selection box right here, we should be getting two vertices, but we're only getting one. And why is that? Well, edges and vertices aren't transparent in nature, so to speak. And we have covered this before in the selection video. So what does that mean? We need to actually turn on X-ray. So let's go Alt-Z for our X-ray. And now when we draw our selection box, you will see that the selection continues on and we have two vertices selected. Right. So we now know that if we select all of this, we'll get four vertices and two edges because they're all overlapping one another. So let's quickly show you my favorite menu, which is the right click menu, the context menu. And right here we have merge vertices and it shows you the shortcut, which is M. Okay, let's use that shortcut then. So M by distance. Let's click that and you can see removed two vertices. And if we open up the dialog box here, we can see that it's merged by distance. So anything of a threshold of 0.0001 millimeters, it has been merged together. Right. Well, let's go ahead and repeat that same operation on the other side. So let's go Shift D, move this to this side. And you know what? I'm getting tired that I'm going to have to manually merge these. Well, not in reality. In reality, I don't use auto merging, what I'm about to show you, because I find that you lose control a little bit. You don't really know when something is automatically merging to one another. So I just want to point that out. However, you might use it a lot more than I do, so I need to show you it. So up here on the top right hand side, we have our auto merge, or if we hit N and go into our tool menu, you will see in options, we have auto merge here too. There are other options to auto merge, but we won't cover them right this minute. So let's just turn on auto merge and let's close that up. Let's use our CAD transforms and let's move this from here to there. And as soon as I left click, you will see that this merge has been done as the selection is instantly going across the other edge. Right. So now I want to show you a little catch that can happen with extruding. This catches out many people, especially in the 3D space. So if we go into our edge selection, first of all, I'm sure you've already noticed that vertices cut off edges. So that's why when we're going here and there's two vertices on there, that cuts it out. So edge selection, we select this edge, we hit E. It's very much like the duplication command from our fundamentals. The operation has already been done. So we can cancel the movement with a right click, but the extrude has already been committed. So we still have our X-ray on right this minute. So let's go ahead and go W. Let's draw a little selection box over here and let's look at the statistics of what's going on. So in that one little space, we have four vertices and four edges. It doesn't look like that, does it? So that's how easy it is to get caught out with overlapping or coplanar edges, faces, and vertices. Now, the quickest way to fix this, if you think you have mesh that isn't quite right, select everything, hit M, and go merge by distance. So you can see here it has removed the two vertices, and that's because it has merged what was going on down there. Okay, let's carry on. Let's create this net of the cube. So let's select this edge. Let's hit E in the Y direction. Let's go minus one and let's hit enter. Great. Let's go up here now. This edge here, E, Y, one, enter. You know what? I'm getting tired of doing the same operation over and over again. Well, there's a shortcut for that. Repeat last operation is Shift R. And that's it. So we have the net of our cube created. However, we have some faces here and I don't really want to deal with them right this minute. So I'm going to go ahead and hit 3, select everything, hit X, and let's delete only faces. Now with our net created, let's quickly save our file. So let's go File, save. Great. So now I want to show you just a couple of little advanced things here in the 2D space, because I don't want to make this video too long. So let's go back into our top view. Let's go into our edge selection, select this edge here, and I want to show off a little add-on that we have. So let's duplicate this edge out, duplicate this edge once again, and give this edge a little bit of a rotation. So within precision modeling, quite often we need to find the intersecting point of two lines. So how could you do this in Blender? It's a little bit complicated, so that's why we have a lovely add-on that you can get to by right-clicking Tiny CAD. And right here, VTX Auto is automatically going to create this intersection point of these two edges. All right, well, there's a different way of having this result. We can select them both, right-click, Tiny CAD, just a vertex at that intersection. Right, now, one of my favorite ways of using Tiny CAD is by getting this edge, moving them on top of each other, and Blender doesn't do so great about intersecting points. However, Tiny CAD has this lovely thing. Right click, Tiny CAD, intersect selected edges. And right here, it has gone ahead and intersected these two edges together. Now, what's really powerful of this is that you could actually have a whole bunch of edges intersecting. So let's go ahead and let's make this a little bit more complicated, like so. And let's give this a rotation like that. We can actually select all of this here, right click, Tiny CAD, and intersect selected edges. And that's it, done. So we can now go ahead and select all these vertices that are on the outside. Let's say that those we didn't want. So let's go X, delete these vertices, and there we have it. And all of this here is joined as you'd expect it. Brilliant. Let me just quickly go over something else that Tiny CAD does, which is if you select three vertices, it's going to try and create the circle that connects these three. So Tiny CAD and this one right here, reconstruct circle center, and there we have it. Now they are not really going where the vertices should be, well, that's because there isn't enough vertex numbers. So let's increase the vertex numbers up, and you'll see there how they intersect all of the vertices. Right, let's go ahead and undo that. And you might be wondering, well, the 3D cursor just popped up there, but that's not the center of these 3 points. How would I get this into the center of those 3 points? Let's quickly move the 3D cursor out here. We have our 3 vertices selected. Let's open up the snapping menu. So Shift S, and let's go cursor to selected. And there you have it. That is the median point, the middle point of those 3 points. Of course, you could do this with only 2 points. So let's select these two, or you could do it with a whole bunch of points. So let's say we wanted the middle of this one. And there you have it. Just something powerful to have in your arsenal to know how to be able to move the 3D cursor to the center of something. Right, there is another one in here, which is this one here, but that's very much for the 3D space, so we're not going to cover that for now. But what I do want to cover is, let's say we wanted to delete this edge right here. Well, let's go ahead and delete it. Let's go into edge selection. Let's get this edge here. Let's hit X and let's delete edge. Now, what do you think has just happened? It's left the vertices behind. Right, so to do that, we need to dissolve these vertices away, because if we were to just delete these, we're going to be destroying our mesh. So what we can do is undoing, let's go X, we have this dissolve menu instead. So let's dissolve the vertices, and that leaves the edges intact. When dissolving edges, that's very much dealing with faces, so we'll deal with that later on. Now there's only one more thing that I want to show you before we wrap up this video, which is we have another add-on called F2. Now, F2 is a little bit of a weird add-on, but it can be very powerful. I'm just going to move the 3D cursor back to the world origin. So F2 does this. If we hit this vertex here and we have our mouse on this side and we hit F, it's going to create this here. I can right-click to cancel the movement of the operation, and that has created exactly what we wanted. So this also works, say if we had just this here, if we go ahead, select that vertex, hit F, that's done the other side. So it's a very quick way of adding more geometry to things. So for instance, if we wanted to do that same operation, we would actually have to go here, then extrude this out, let's go 1 millimeter in the Y, and now we know that we have these overlapping edges. Oh no, they've auto-merged because I had auto-merging on. However, if we didn't have auto-merge, that would not have happened. So it's just something to keep in mind that the F2 add-on can be extremely powerful in the right situation, which is why I just wanted to show you it right here in action before we got any deeper into showing you it in a much more complicated setting. Well done through getting through the first steps of 2D precision modeling. Yes, there is a lot more to cover, but I think this is a good point to stop, take a rest, and have a go at the little something extra that I have for you at the end of this video. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it's the reason why I'm making these videos right here. And if you're enjoying what I'm making and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord, and that is linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue. For the bold of you that want to take the information you've just learned into some real-world application, I have this small little floor plan down in the description. You can download this entire file to work with, or just the image. It's up to you how hard you want to make this for yourself. If you need a helping hand to solve this, the solution video is down there too.